Hello, everyone. It's Roseanne. I am live, and I am going to try to work on this page that we've been working on. Let me just trying to set something up here. I don't know what's going on here. Just a sec. All right. I was trying to get my old phone to work. I don't know why it's not working though. So give me a second here. And I don't know if, Okay, I don't know. I don't know what I'm doing here. I don't know. I'm just gonna turn this other phone off because it's not working. All right, I'm not wasting time. What I have here is I was watching Ivy, and she recently did like a challenge video for somebody who's having a challenge, and I guess today was the last day. And she was showing these boxes that she made out of tubes. I guess I'm not familiar, but the challenge was create something out of tubes, and she made these really pretty storage boxes. Well, on the front of them, she was showing that she used some bottle caps that she said she had bought from someone. Again, I don't know who, if you want to go over and check out Ivy's channel, please do so. And it gave me an idea. So right away, I just jumped on it. I have this little thing here these are all my little fiber bits that I'm gonna probably be using today, because you know, after a while, they just get jam packed, and you know, you cut a piece and I don't throw them away. I always just save stuff. So, I used the outside of this to just get a piece of cardstock, you know, draw a circle, right? Some people have those circle cutters. I don't have one. I don't have a punch this size, I don't think. Actually, it's a 2-inch. I think I do, actually, now that I think about it. No, this is 2 3/4. I think my punch is, the one that I have is 2 inches. But if you have a punch, you know, you could punch out a circle. I just draw it and cut around. And then what I did was I just took my stylus. This is called a stylus, and it was back in the good old days when we used to, you know, make cards, and we'd do dry embossing under the, you know, the box light and stuff. Anyway, all I did was just go around just using my eyeball. You never measure stuff. But trying to keep the same amount of distance all the way around the edge. And I just use the stylish to do this. And I just wanted to put this on video so that I don't forget. Because sometimes I'll forget. Okay, so I'm going to get rid of this. And then I have, you know, a bottle of water, a bottle of alcohol. This one's alcohol. And all I did was just, I use alcohol because it evaporates quickly. And I only need it to be wet for a little while. So, you know, you can spread it. This is 91%. And all you do is just pinch. And, you know, push down where you, what do you call that? No, I'm tearing this one because I creased it too much. But yeah, that's all you do. And you've got yourself a cute little bottle cap, right? Paper bottle cap. And depending on how close away you are from the edge, you can make it much deeper, you know? If you make your indentation over here, or emboss, if you embossed over here, then this is going to be really tall. And if you embossed, you know, just right around the edges, then it's going to be really short. So, and then see now all of the alcohol, it's evaporating away. And it's almost dry. See, this one's dry. And now you can add your pictures or your glossy accents or, you know, whatever you need. Look at how cute that would look. A little ruffle, glue it down, put something, I don't know, maybe a cute little embellishment for junk journals. I'll probably stick these in my junk journals now that I've made a couple. You know, you can throw an image in there. See how cute that is? And you can always make these closer together, you know, if you want. Cutesy. So I just wanted to share that with you guys. It just kind of came to me. If you don't have those bottle caps, you can make them with cardstock and make them any size you want. So, yeah. Okay, let's put that away. I've got my glue gun going already, and I'm just going to clean the gunk. Clean the yucky gunk. Okay. And I'm going to raise this up a little bit so you guys get a good view of what I'm doing. Maybe turn this to the side a little bit. I know I should always do this before I start, but most of the time I don't. Guys, sorry. How's everyone doing? Hope everyone's doing good. Yesterday we took a break because we had friends. Well, there are renters. We have two houses that we rent out in Trona that my husband bought. We are flippers, and well, we were before the COVID. And we're not like, you know, we don't do it all the time, but whenever we have an opportunity. So we bought a couple of houses on auction at a really good price. They needed to be rehabbed. We rehabbed them, and we rented them out. It's in a very low income area. But all of our renters, but these particular renters are very good friends of ours. And they came over to spend the day with us. Her mom, her name is Lupita, and Chris. Chris is her husband. Lupita's mom lives here in Flint, I think, and when they come down to visit her mom, then they come down and visit us. So anyway, let's get started. They came over yesterday. We spent the day with them, and we karaoke'd in the evening, and we had a really fun time. So it's always nice. We haven't gone anywhere. We haven't done anything. So it's always nice to have, you know, some kind of entertainment, I guess, during these days that we can't go anywhere, for goodness sakes. Okay, we need to do this page, and we left off where I just glued that down, and I asked everyone to do homework. If you're following with me, go get a stick from your yard. I got this stick here. It's this branch. We have a bunch of trees because we're in the desert. Our trees dry out because it's really expensive to water everything. So we'll water like maybe every other week the trees. But for the most part, they have to like find their own water. And in the desert, you know, they're already desert tolerant. So a lot of the trees die, and I have a lot of these branches, and we've got a lot of weird desert weeds, and I'm just gonna put that to the side. I liked the shape of this because it looks like a tree, right? A mini tree. It's almost the right size, but it's bent forward, so I don't know if I'm gonna. I have a wire cutter here. These scissors are really heavy duty to cut wires. I'm gonna see if I can break it because I want it to be flat. I don't want it, you know, I guess it's okay, but and I want it smaller, so maybe I'll have to I'm looking for a mat. Maybe I can use my what do you call it? And you know what? I may not even use this. This is really hard. What I need is a mini saw. And I have a Dremel, but, you know, hubby took it. You know how that goes. They take the tools and then God knows where they put them. He needed it, you know, to work on one of the houses. And I don't use it too often, so. But when I do need it, I have no idea where it's at. Okay, so I'm just gonna trying to get it started so that when I bend it, it's gonna break where I want it to break. And as I said, these are wire cutters or metal cutter scissors. So I just wanna get it started. I don't want to break all this. Oh, perfect. Look at that. Okay. And this one, you know, you can always paint it and do something. So I'm going to actually keep this. And these I might just glue into the bottom over there. So I might even take some of this off or something. So let's get started doing this. I've been excited. I think it's going to be kind of fat. And that's why I wanted the. I don't know why I didn't think about it. I just kind of started working on stuff and I didn't put the tree on the other side of the page. Okay, so let's get this off the table here. And I hope that music isn't loud. I'm gonna turn it down. I feel like I'm yelling over the music and I don't want to get dinged. Okay, so what I had mentioned is I want to get some fibers, and since we're going with green, I'm just going to pull this out of the way and let's see what we have here. There's just grab whatever color you're going to use. That might be nice. And I know I like that one. That's one that Nola sent me and I have some, so I'm going to pull that out. There's a piece of really skinny fabric. And there's some kind of green and autumn color. So grab your little fibers. That's some green and there's some pink in that black there, so that's good. What's this one? This one's a little bit of green and blue. And a little purple. I don't think I'll use the purple, but I could use the blue. There we go. And the pink. Okay, I think that's going to be enough. I'm pulling out a lot and I don't really, we don't really need that much. There's a little bit of blue there. Just pull out your little scraps. Let's see, what is this? Yep, that's more green and blue. Okay, little bits. There's some gray. I like that one. I always like to mix some light and dark. Okay, and I could have done this off camera to save time. You know me, the time just flies. And then I feel like I don't get a lot done for the live. And I really want you guys to get the most out of, you know, the live each time you watch, so that you come back. And I can't see everyone if you're just joining me. I don't know how to turn the chat stuff on. I'm just going to glue this on. Okay, I'm just going to start. I'm going to wrap. I'm not talking to anybody because I can't see your chats. I think you have to have another device, because what I see on this camera is just what I'm doing so that I can make sure I stay in screen. And so, and on my desktop, I have the music going, so I guess I could go to my channel and see the live there, but then we wouldn't have background music. So I don't know what to do here. But I like the music. It kind of keeps me calm and just kind of keeps me going. So I'm just going to cover. And I'm just going to use all different colors. I think I like this one. I'm going to use this one towards... I should have used that one towards the bottom. Because you always want to use the dark colors in the bottom. For grounding, you know. Shadows. Darker colors are always towards the center or towards the bottom of your projects. Because of the shadows. I'm just going to do this. Just wrap it around any which way. I'm going to have the light coming from this way. You know, you have to think about where your light. Maybe I'll have the light coming in this way. Yeah. So think about if you had a light shining here going that way, then all your shadows are going to be, see, on this side of the page. So you want all your darker colors, you know, maybe on just one side, so that on this side you show the light. This is all color theory, light theory. I've taken many classes, art classes, way in the past when I was younger. And so people always ask, how do you mix stuff? Things just go together. And there is kind of a color theory on how to mix colors and how to put even colors that don't go together, how to put them together so that they do go together. And there's a certain way. And I've been thinking of opening a Patreon and maybe teaching some of those classes, but I don't have time right now. You know, color theory and composition and all of those, you know, like, all those classes I did that have helped me, I'm sure, you know, they will help others. And kind of all artist classes that you've got to take. To be proficient. And anyway, this is not a commercial. I want some of this because I like the baubles. So I'm going to put, yeah, that's going to be on that side. So I have to keep in mind that this is going to be over here on the sides, and this is the front. That's going to be the back. So I don't care what the back looks like. Although that looks really cute. Oh, well, never mind. I'm gonna just start wrapping. And then see all this bushy bobble stuff. That is gonna add so much. Pull it tight and have it. So much to our project. Once we start putting on the leaves and all that, it's going to look really, super cool, all these baubles. You can get pieces of fabric, you know, like this, and just add it. You know, it's really simple to add texture, to add, I'm just gonna fold it in half so it looks like a leaf. Okay, fold it in half and just add it. Just like that, see? And then you can add like a little, it didn't stick quite as well. And then you can add like just a little, one of these, like a little knot. This I made because I wanted to put dangles, you know, you put knots and then you can put your dangles and keep them separated. But you can use these little knots. I love working with knots. I once did a big wall hanging back in the day. I've done fiber arts a long time, and I meant to bring the one that I did for my woodland journal. I did a lot of the fiber art in the woodland journal that I created for Jeanette, who is my cottage crafts. So see, just do little knots. And so that doesn't look like a piece of material folded, you know, you could just add like a little, I hope you're seeing, add like a little knot, and let's get close. Look, see? So it looks like, you know, a really intricate tree, you know, little leaves, and that's how you just keep going. Just keep going. Now I'm gonna add this green. I guess I should glue it. We're probably gonna spend the whole 40 minutes doing this because this does take a little bit of time, just so that you can get it just right, how you want it. You could use thread, you could use embroidery thread, you could use, Nola gave me some really pretty wool, which I'm gonna use that for the branches. It didn't come in the kit, I'm sorry ladies. But I'm gonna use that for the branches and the leaves once we get this down. And I need to put a little bit of glue so that it doesn't fray. Okay. Just a tiny bit of glue. This is just, you know, it's just yarn, it's just fiber. Okay, and I hope I have enough for all of the branches. I don't think I will. So I'm just gonna go up halfway here. Because I want to make sure I get it on all the branches. And I hope you guys are enjoying the series. And I hope I can learn how to do this better for you guys. And maybe one day be able to talk with you guys. Okay, I'm just gonna oh, I don't even need to put any on the back because that's going to be the back just to save. I'm just going to add a piece like this. Oh, but I want it to, yeah, never mind. I want it to have that bulky look. So, you know, that dimensional look like the branches or the trunk of the tree. Okay, and I'm sorry if this is boring, guys. So yesterday when my friends were here, we were talking about conspiracy theories. I don't know if you guys watch conspiracy theories, believe in them. I'm a big follower of true crime, and I'm a big follower of conspiracy theories, and I get a lot of enjoyment. Pastime. Sometimes when I'm working and I'm not filming, I'll put those true crime videos on or court TV, I will just sit and listen, or sometimes I'll put music on, watch a movie, and then just get busy, just get lost. Okay, I'm gonna cut that there. I want to make sure I have a little bit here and a little bit here. I got started on working on my doily book kit. So I'm gonna have a doily book kit soon, ladies. Well, after I finish this series. And I'm gonna sell a few doily book kits. I showed the doilies in one of the other videos. I'm cutting them up now. Let me just show you here. They're these. You'll get six of these, sets of two, and then I just wove in between here and just tied with the tulle. So you'll have all of that, and I'll do all of that online. I'm going to have some laces, and I'm going to go through how I made my cupcake doily book, a step by step. A couple people have asked for a tutorial, so I will do that. So if you're interested, once that doily, but keep an eye out. Once I finish making that kit up, I'm doing a little by little in between this series. I'll have them for sale, and then if you want to buy one, you'll be able to follow along with me. You'll have everything that you need in that kit to create the cupcake doily book. So stay tuned for that. Okay. Oops. Can't get that. It got caught in the on the branch. Now this is the back. I don't really care if the glue shows, but I want it to be tacked down there. Okay, I need more over here. Maybe I'll just. I wish I had more of that. Let me see if I have more. And if not, it's okay. It will be okay. Ooh, this is some that I got from my sweet friend. It's kind of close. This green part. Yeah. From my sweet friend, Susan. Oh my gosh, I'm forgetting her channel right now. She doesn't go on YouTube very often. Oh gosh, I forgot her name. Oh, sweetie pie, I'm sorry. I love her. She sent me a beautiful, beautiful fabric gift. And she sent me some fibers and some flowers that she made, and she bought one of my art flowers, and Shoshana 8. Good golly. Sorry, sweetheart, I forgot about your channel. She's so talented, but she doesn't do too many videos. I wish she would do more videos. I miss you, girl. Anyway, she sent me a package of fibers also. Everybody knows I love fibers. I just absolutely, and I work with them all the time. How's my time? 30 minutes. See, 30 minutes, and we haven't done anything but wrap the tree. Doggone it. And now I'm spending time with this. Just wasting time. Trying to find some green, some dark green. I really don't have any. I love green. I always use green, so green is in short supply for me. There, that's a little bit of green. There's some green there. Just so that it's similar. It's okay if it's not going to be, you know, exactly the right tone. Even brown is good. Okay, I just need a little. Okay, I'm going to use this and this. And let's get this off my table. So what else can I talk about? Not a big talker. I don't have the gift of gab. Some people can just, you know, talk about a lot of cool stuff, and I'm just more of a quiet, analytical type of person. I'm not much for small talk, and you know, I'm more, I like to have more substantial conversations. I don't know. I'm weird. I'm just weird. I'm not too worried about that glue showing because that's going to be on the back. And I shouldn't have even wrapped it because it's going to be on the back. See, when I talk, I don't pay attention. And in fact, I'm just going to break that off if I can without breaking the other branches. Because that's going to stick it up. You know what I mean? It's going to make it not lay flat. Why didn't I think about that? Duh, see, now it'll lay, and this is going up, but I want that branch over there. Oh my gosh, okay, well, let's do this. I want to wrap this one. Just hold it down. While I wrap it, and since this is live, I guess, you know, people that are on, that are watching can chat amongst themselves. If there's anyone watching, I don't know how to see that as well. I mean, for all I know, there's nobody watching. It's okay. Okay. And I want green here, so I'm going to use this one. Start it in the back. So there's no glue showing. Okay. There's a little divot right there that I need to, I can't. It's hard to get the fiber through that little space. I don't really know why I'm being so meticulous right now, because this is probably all going to be covered with the branches, the tree branches that we choose, that I choose to use. Okay, there we go. Okay, look at this mess here. How's my time? Okay. Gonna save this little guy because it might be a leaf or something, and those can get gone. All right, I want background, and I decided I'm gonna use more of this one. I really think I want it this way because it's gonna lay flatter. Oh yeah, that is, because that's where the shadows are on this side. Duh. Okay, so I want to, I was looking at this. This was folded over and I unsewed it. And I saw this. And because Rhonda suggested dragonfly, thank you, sweetheart, I am going to cut this in a manner that it might be a dragonfly. So, thank you. Thank you so much for the idea. And, hi everyone, if you're just coming in. I'm new at the, let's see, how does, yeah, this way, so that one and that one and that one. Let's cut this. I'm new at the live, so I don't know how to see the chats and stuff yet. I'll get better. So for right now, if you're asking me questions, I can't see them. I'm sorry. Yeah, that's cute. And then this one can be short. And this idea was given to me by Rhonda. If you have an idea of something you would like to see me do or add or use, I'm trying to use all of Nola's goodies. I am adding my own stuff, though. And it's not because Nola didn't do a good job at her kit. Her kit is beautiful. Her kit is a fabric kit. And she sells inspiration fabric kits so that we can take them and make them our own. So she's not gonna supply all of the little tchotchkes, you know. She's gonna give you a great price on fabrics, and then all of us have our own little blings and stuff, so she doesn't need to do that. She doesn't need to supply all that stuff. We all have it. Isn't that gorgeous? Look, Rhonda. Pretty. Okay, so this I thought I would put over here. Right? Cutesy? Thank you, girl. Great idea. And I think there was another lady, too. I know Rhonda, though. Well, I don't know her, but we do communicate via YouTube quite often. She leaves comments all the time, and we talk via Look at how cute that is. I'm still leaving this open because we might. I think I'm going to add some tulle, but we'll see at the end. Okay, so let's go over here again. I want to bring some more of that behind the tree. So all of the scraggler pieces that aren't anything, I'm going to cut that away from, maybe this could be another butterfly or another dragonfly later. So I'm not going to cut into that, but I can use this that isn't anything. And thinking, oh, I added this. I didn't add it, but I did. This was this piece. So I'm going to glue it down here. I just stuck it back there so that I could remember. So let's do that before I do anything else. Just going to add. Can you guys see what I'm doing? Okay, I have to look at the screen. So I'll show you. This is just... this lace came with the kit from Nola, and right there. And I'm just going to cut there where it bends because I don't want it to fold. I want it to just tuck right in there. Because I don't need the extra bulk. I already have bulk from the front page. Okay. And I just thought this, don't they look cute, the little flowers? Oh my gosh, it looks like there's flowers growing on the ground. But over here, it's going to be like a background. Okay, now this kind of looked to me like, you know, some brush or some, maybe I could. Yep, let's do like that. I wish I could flip it, but that's the wrong side. It might be okay though if I flipped it. Yeah, I think I like that, so I'm gonna do that. I wanna make sure the fuzzy is forward because I want the fuzzy to be fuzzy. And I'm gonna be layering other stuff in there. This is going to be backwards. Yep, it's going to be a little backwards, but it's okay. Texture. Careful, the glue is hot. I'm just using my nails. Okay, and then I can push the fuzzy forward. And I want to lay that down in the background. And I'm going to have to trim it a little, I guess. Just a little, because I want to be able to have this lace hold it in place. So let's do that. Where's my, there it is. Okay, and then I can add the lace over top, and then I can add this over top. Oh gosh, that almost fell on my lap. Woo, that was a close one. Oh my gosh. That go along the edge. Okay, very nice. I'm liking how it's turning out. How's my time? Let me know if you guys want to see longer videos. I would love to, or longer lives. I've been trying to keep them short so that I have an audience that's, you know, interested in watching and not being bored to death. All the tedious things. I do so many tedious little extra detailed. It just takes me longer. I a fast grader, and I'm going to leave that up in case I want to put something down there. I like to enjoy my process. I don't want to be rushed. This is my therapy. It's what I love to do. I'm very passionate about it. When I create from my whole heart. And I just want to enjoy every moment, especially during today, you know, these darn COVID days. I haven't seen my great-granddaughter in person for months, and it just breaks my heart. She's growing up. She's crawling. The last time I saw her, she was in my arms sleeping most of the day. She was a month old, and now she's talking and crawling, and I feel like I'm missing so much. What can you do, you know? What can you do? Okay, I'm stalling. I don't know why. Okay, here we go. I love that knot hole. Is that not the coolest thing, that little knot hole? Realistic. Oh my God, I love it. Okay, so now that we have all of this and we have this, I want to put something else here. Darn it. I'm going to do this. I'm going to bring some of this green up in here. Okay. Because I want to highlight, you know, a little bit of light in the background. And I'm just going to do this. Okay, and then this. I'm just going to spread it this way. This is going to be the backlight of everything that we're going to do. Just a little bit of this is going to show from underneath of the entire, of the focal point. You're going to have these highlights in the background. That's what this is serving. I want more of this. Do I have more? I don't. Okay, well, you know what? I'm just going to do this. We have color over here. We don't have blue, but that's okay. Okay. And I'm just going to tack that down so that it's not, what is that, flapping around. And maybe we'll have a little bit of color underneath what we're going to do. Oh, I'm so excited to show you what I'm going to do. This is my favorite. I am mainly mixed media and a fiber creator. I hate saying fiber artist because it sounds presumptuous and I don't want that. So I will call myself a creator. Okay, there you go. Isn't that cool so far? I hope you guys are liking it. Okay, then, this is the back, right? Yes, I want to put more tulle. That's right, okay. Anyway, my mind's going 1,000 miles an hour because this is where I live. I love the abstract. I love the fiber. I'm going to glue this down now that we've got some tooth. This is all called tooth so that it will hold on to your main, whatever it is, focal point. In our case, it's a tree. So I'm just going to like set it down. Oh, like that, kind of in the center of the page. I know it's floating. We're going to work on that. And see here, you can see layers. You can see the tulle. You can see the lace. You can see this. You're going to see this after this. So this will be the last thing that we do. You can see this. You can still see the tulle in the back, right? You can see all the layers. And then we're going to build up here, and we're going to build up here. And this is really going to be a bulky page. I really want it over there. I should have switched it, but what can you do when you don't pay attention? I'm just adding glue in the back. I want it to lay as flat as it can be. Okay. How much time? Oh gosh, 51 minutes. I wish somebody could say, do you want me to keep going or shall I stop here? How about I go 5 more minutes and then I'll stop. Okay. Nola's beautiful fibers. This came with the kit, but she also sent me in the past, and I'm sure you guys have this kind of stuff. I'm going to use this one. So I'm going to grab, it's like spun wool, I think it's called. So I'm just going to chop some off. I love this. Nola, I love this. Okay. And this is the fun part. I'm just going to add some glue. Let's start here. I'm going to glue that down. And I'm going to cut it. And then whatever comes off, and that's going to be too sharp for the corner, so I'm just going to break it off right there. And I think I'm going to break this off because they don't need to be. We're going to get, I have that part and that part that's wood that makes it realistic. So, okay. Okay, are you guys seeing? Are you guys seeing it? Oh, I'm so excited. I love this. And just stick it down. I know my crafting is not like other people with laces and stuff. I mean, I do all of that stuff, but this is, I love this. This is what I do. This is what I feel I do the best in all of my, the other crafting I don't think I do very well. I'm okay, but there's so many talented ladies out there that I'm just going to cut first. So many more talented ladies that have beautiful laces and beautiful expensive, you know, stuff. And I love the scraps. I love the bits and pieces. Where's my little, what do you guys think so far? Pretty? Okay. Don't forget, guys, if you like, thumbs up, share. If you're learning something, you want to leave me a comment, something, a question. You want to suggest something, you'd like me to talk about a certain topic, ghost stories, or I don't know. Just put it in the comments. Let me know. I feel sometimes like I'm boring because I don't know what to talk about. Can't wait till we get to here. I'm going to put some more of this green over here, and then we're going to start using the other colors. So, just let me know, guys, what you want to hear, what you'd like to see added to this book and pertaining to this book. And if I can, you know, from your suggestions, I can think of a way to do it using Nola's goodies. You guys, I'm trying to use all her goodies. I am adding stuff, but it's because my creativity needs certain things, you know, to fulfill my vision. Fancy smancy talking, huh? I have to laugh at myself. Okay, oh, we need glue. So we're gonna add the brown right here in the back, right? In the back, because shadows. You know, when you look at something, you want the depth. I'm gonna add some down here. The way that you present your colors, your composition, leads your eye and gives you dimension. The way that you use the colors and where you place them, where the light is shining, the angle of the light that you want shining on your project. So see, if you went like this, see, doesn't it look like, you know, your shadows are down at the bottom, right? So there we go. I'm gonna give it a little haircut. Okay, and then I'm gonna add some of this blue over here. Okay, and then we want some brown down here. Just right under here. I mean, you can see, when you look at it, you can see where all the shadows are from your light. And you could use this technique when you're stamping, when you're painting, when you're, you know, making your doily books. I want to just add a little right here. Yep. And then we need some down here, of course, but really close to the bottom, because we're going to have more foliage coming out at the top. So now that we've gotten to the brown, I want a little up here on this side, because remember I said the light's coming from this way, so there's going to be shadows on this side. And then I don't want to cover all of this up, because what's the point of adding that color in there? Maybe it'll look like a blossom. You know, what's the point of adding all that color if you're just going to cover it up? So when I think of layers, I love layers, but I never want to cover them up. I want to see every single layer. Otherwise, why use a layer there, right? Is that not pretty? I hope you guys are liking. Okay, I've been on for an hour. This is so much fun. I don't want to stop. But I'm going to stop here because I don't want the lives to go so long. I realize people have lives and things to do. So let me know what you guys are thinking so far. And come back. I'm going to be back on tomorrow. We'll finish this, hopefully, maybe. There's still a lot to go. So we've got some other textures I'm going to be adding. And yeah. Okay, guys. Thank you so much, those of you who stopped by. And those of you who are sharing and thumbs upping and all that stuff. Hope you like. Nola, thank you so much. I love everything so much. And yeah. Bye, everyone. God bless.